BGMC. The biblical truth lives here. Ancient Hebrew scriptures foretold of the Anointed One, Yeshua HaMashiach. The Messiah Yeshua came to call the people back to the truth of His Word and to follow that righteous path. Yeshua then called Jewish men to be His disciples, and after His death and resurrection, those Jewish men told the world about the Jewish Messiah. Now, after 2,000 years, Beth Goyim Messianic Congregation has that same calling of those Jewish men, telling all people, both Jew and Gentile, about the proper ancient path, teaching the Route 66 King's Highway from Genesis through to Revelation, and how you need and can get back to the proper roots of the faith and a closer walk with God. Now, let's hear the message.
Okay, this class,
esta clase,
is called Jehovah's Rules of Engagement.
Se llaman las reglas de Jehová para atacar.
Now this outline is a whole page in my teeny tiny writing, so I'm promising you it's all we're going to get to today.
Esto tiene una hoja completa de la pequeña letras que yo escribo.
So, in Jehovah's Rules of Engagement, there are three different kingdoms we're having to deal with.
En las reglas de Jehová para atacar, hay tres diferentes reinos el cual tenemos que tratar con ellos.
We have a very unique situation here in the United States.
Tenemos una situación única aquí en los Estados Unidos.
We do not have separate kingdoms occupying separate pieces of soil.
Aquí no tenemos reinos separados ocupando tierras separadas.
We have distinctly different kingdoms occupying the same soil.
Tenemos diferentes reinos ocupando la misma tierra, el mismo lugar.
Our kingdom is not all one people, and our enemy kingdom is not all one people that all look alike either.
Nuestro reino no es todo un mismo pueblo y nuestro enemigo tampoco es un mismo pueblo y todo no se parecen.
So for the world, for the secular people,
entonces para el mundo secular,
they come to me and ask, it's a very confusing situation for them.
Ellos vienen y me preguntan, esto es algo muy confuso.
A lot of these guys in the Patriot movement tend to look at immigrants.
Muchas veces estos hombres, parte de estos grupos patriotas, ellos tienden a ver a los inmigrantes
like they're really not part of us,
como que no son parte de nosotros,
like an enemy,
como un enemigo.
But here in the scriptures we will find,
pero aquí en las escrituras vamos a encontrar,
that many of you guys,
que muchos de ustedes,
are actually part of the religious patriot movement,
que son parte de este movimiento religioso
inside of this country,
dentro de este país.
So you're part of one specific kingdom.
Ustedes son parte de un reino específico.
Oh, that's God's kingdom.
Y este es el reino de Dios.
So the way to determine who is actually God's kingdom,
y la forma de determinar ¿quién es realmente parte del reino de Dios?
Who is a citizen?
¿Quién es un ciudadano?
What is a citizen's responsibilities?
¿Cuáles son las responsabilidades de un ciudadano?
To be a citizen in God's kingdom,
para ser un ciudadano en el reino de Jehová,
you have to keep the Shabbat.
Tienes que guardar el sábado.
That is the first identifying marker.
Esta es la primera marca para identificar.
So all of those Sunday Christians,
todos estos que hacen el domingo, que guardan el domingo,
they may not be Amalekites,
Ellos tal vez no sean amalecitas,
but they're certainly not Israelites.
Pero ciertamente no son israelitas tampoco.
The people who have an indifference to God,
las personas que tienen una indiferencia para con Dios,
are not necessarily in the same kingdom as those engaged in full-on disgusting practices that God intends to sweep away.
No están, no son necesariamente parte de estas prácticas de las cuales el Eterno está decidido a deshacerse de ellas.
Now, how many of you Latin people have ever heard there needs to be a path to citizenship?
¿Cuánto de ustedes como latinos han escuchado hay un camino hacia la ciudadanía?
You're not Latin, Rabbi Andrew. You, but hey, you're a Yankee, so you are a foreigner here in Lexington.
¿Quiénes de ustedes han escuchado esa palabra? Un camino hacia la ciudadanía.
So everybody who's paid attention to anything knows what people are talking about when they say a path to citizenship.
Cualquiera que haya prestado atención a algo de esto va a entender esto de un camino hacia la ciudadanía.
We know in the United States a path to citizenship means, hey, vote for me, I'll give you welfare and I'll give you a citizenship card and you got it made, right?
Aquí en los Estados Unidos sabemos que un camino hacia la ciudadanía es, hey, vota por mí, te daré cheques al fin de mes y tendrás todas las lo que necesites.
But in God's kingdom,
pero en el reino del Eterno,
path to citizenship for a foreigner,
el camino hacia la ciudadanía para un extranjero,
that is somebody that's not keeping the Shabbat and not keeping the holy days.
Esto es alguien que no guarda el Shabbat, que no guarda el día santo.
Is something quite different than, you know, just say you love me, just say you love Jesus and you're in.
Es diferente a decir simplemente, oh, yo amo a Jesús y ya eres parte de nosotros.
So, beyond the Shabbat,
más allá del Shabbat,
the questions I've got here are why keep the Shabbat?
Las preguntas que yo tengo aquí es ¿por qué tengo que guardar el Shabbat?
Who has to keep the Shabbat?
¿Quién tiene que guardar el Shabbat?
When is the Shabbat?
¿Cuándo es el Shabbat?
Where?
¿Dónde?
To keep the Shabbat?
¿Dónde tengo que guardar el Shabbat?
And how do you do it?
¿Y cómo lo hago?
So Shabbat's a little more complicated than just saying, okay, well, we go to synagogue on Saturday, right?
Entonces, guardar el sábado es un poco más complicado que simplemente decir, oh, yo voy a la sinagoga el sábado.
Or we go to church on Sunday.
O decir, yo voy a la iglesia el domingo.
But the Sunday keeper,
pero los que guardan el domingo,
while they are not part of God's kingdom,
mientras que ellos no son parte del reino de Dios,
there is a path to citizenship.
Si hay un camino hacia la ciudadanía.
Because, see, like one day we were over here in Latin America.
Porque veamos, un día estábamos aquí en Latinoamérica.
In the Sunday church.
En la iglesia del domingo.
And we wanted to move to the United States.
Nos queríamos ir a los Estados Unidos.
So we'd get over here and do that.
Nos vimos aquí a los Estados Unidos y hacemos eso.
But we got to go on Saturday.
Pero tenemos que hacerlo el sábado.
So for a lot of these Sunday people,
entonces para muchos de esos que guardan el domingo,
in the conflict that is coming,
en el conflicto que está a punto de llegar o que está en camino,
there can be a path to citizenship.
Puede haber un camino hacia la ciudadanía.
Now the next thing beyond the Shabbat, now listen, we're going to get really in depth. Next week, we're going to start with Shabbat, and we're going to get really in-depth with Scripture and a lot of references on that. But for this time, we're just going over the outline of things, so you get ready for what's coming in the next several weeks.
Realmente, la próxima semana vamos a entrar en una profundidad en esto del Shabbat. Vamos a tener muchas citas bíblicas, y vamos a profundizar mucho para así saber lo que está a punto de venir en las próximas semanas de acuerdo a las enseñanzas que el Rabino Well nos va a traer. Pero ahora simplemente lo que está haciendo es dándonos una, un resumen de lo que está, en lo que él va a traer.
So beyond the Shabbat, it's the Kadosh Mikras, the Holy Convocations, and the Rosh Kodesh.
Más allá del Shabbat son las convocaciones santas y los días santos.
So we're going to go over in this and the Kadosh Mikras, we're going to go over how many Shabbats there are and how many Rosh Kodeshes there are in a year.
Entonces, en esto de los Kadosh Mikra, los días santos, vamos a ver cuántos Shabbat hay en un año y cuántos Rosh Kodesh o lunas del primer mes hay.
We're going to go over who has to do those.
Y vamos a estar estudiando quiénes son los que tienen que hacer eso.
We're going to go over the purpose of why they were commanded.
Y vamos a ir también a tratar el propósito por cuál fue que fueron encomendados que teníamos que hacerlo.
We're going to go over specific scriptures about when they are.
Y también vamos a estar estudiando escrituras específicas en qué tiempo son.
And we're going to go over specific scriptures on where you have to do this stuff.
Y también vamos a estar tratando con escrituras específicas dónde tienes que hacer estos.
And I'll give you a little hint on that one. Every one of them says, no matter where you live.
Y les voy a dar una pequeña parte, un pedacito de esto. Y dice, donde quiera que te encuentres.
Okay, so now that stuff is going to be part of your path to citizenship.
Ahora, lo que te estoy dando, esto va a ser parte de tu camino hacia la ciudadanía.
Now.
Ahora.
Beyond that, we get into rules for life for the citizen.
Más allá de eso, nos vamos a ir la vida, reglas para la vida de un ciudadano.
As a citizen,
como un ciudadano,
if you're accused of breaking any of these rules,
si tú eres acusado de quebrantar alguna de estas reglas,
you have a right to a trial.
Tú tienes el derecho de un juicio.
You have specific punishments that are handed down in Scripture for the citizen.
Hay castigos específicos que se nos dan en la Biblia para un extranjero que quebrantó un mandamiento, una ley.
Now, beyond the citizen, the rules for foreigners.
Ahora, más allá de esto de los ciudadanos para los extranjeros.
That's more complicated and that's going to take a lot longer than the rules for the citizen.
Esto para la ley para los extranjeros es más complicado y va a tomar más tiempo que hablar sobre las leyes para los ciudadanos.
There are several different categories of foreigner.
Hay diferentes categorías de extranjeros.
There is the foreigner that is in your country.
Ahí el extranjero que está en tu país.
There is the foreigner that you meet in battle.
Hay el extranjero el cual te encuentras con él en batalla o en tiempo de guerra.
There is a foreigner that you've conquered, they've agreed to become part of you.
Hay extranjeros que tú conquistas y ellos están de acuerdo en ser parte de tu país.
There are enemy nations that the Lord commanded you to purge and completely exterminate.
Hay naciones enemigas que el Eterno dice que tienes que exterminarlos completamente.
And there are foreigners that the Lord has given you the option to absorb into the nation if you wish.
Y hay extranjeros que el Eterno si tú deseas, puedes absorberlos, o sea, hacerlos parte de tu país si deseas de esa forma.
Now, to that end,
ahora, para ese punto,
we're going to have to say who can be absorbed.
Nosotros vamos a tener que decir quiénes pueden ser absorbidos.
Now, who cannot be absorbed?
¿Quién no puede ser?
What is the difference?
¿Cuál es la diferencia?
And why is there a big difference?
¿Y por qué hay una gran diferencia?
So now that's my outline. Have I run out of time yet? Just about 10 more minutes. All right. Well, then I tell you what, on Jehovah's rules of engagement.
Ahora les voy a dar, hablando sobre las reglas del Eterno para la...
Open up your phones.
Abran sus teléfonos. O sea, la Biblia.
Yeah, open the tablet.
Abran las tabletas.
We'll go to the first rule that makes someone a citizen. We're gonna talk about how you're a citizen first. Because really, if you learn how to be a citizen in God's kingdom, it really doesn't matter what your background is, what your skin color is, where you came from, what you did before you knew the Lord or anything else. If you know the rules to be in the kingdom, really the rest of this outline is not going to matter, because once you're in the kingdom and you're obeying God's rules, you know, even if they kill you, you've got it made. So that's why I put this first.
Realmente para esta parte de esta ley de atacar en Yeshua y ser parte de su reino, en realidad, para tú ser parte del reino del Eterno, no necesita, no importa tu color, no importa tu raza, no importa de dónde vengas, si quieres ser parte de él. Lo voy a resumir. O sea, le estoy resumiendo lo que él dijo, porque dijo bastante.
Okay, so we all know the scripture in Bereshit about Shabbat being holy.
Todos conocemos esta escritura en Génesis o Bereshit sobre que el día Shabbat es santo.
We're not going to that one.
Bueno, no nos vamos a esa.
We're going to go to Shemot 31:12.
No, nos vamos a Éxodo 31:12 primero. Éxodo 31:12.
If you guys are in CJB, that's page 96.
Si están en la Biblia completa judía, esta es la página 96.
If you're in something else, you're on your own.
Si estás en cualquier otra Biblia, bueno, estás por ti solo.
But here's another thing about the CJB. If you're reading CJB, it's good.
Aquí hay otra parte de la Biblia completa judía. Si la estás leyendo, es bueno.
Always check the wording against the Hebrew.
Siempre busca la palabra en contra del hebreo. O sea, que paralela con el hebreo.
So Shemot 31:12.
Éxodos 31:12.
We'll read it. Jehovah said to Moshe, tell the people of Israel you are to observe my Shabbats. For this is a sign between me and you throughout all your generations, so that you will know that I am Jehovah who sets you apart for me. Therefore, you are to keep my Shabbat, because it is set apart for you. Everyone who treats it as ordinary is to be put to death, for whoever does any work on it is to be cut off from his people. So, if you're to be put to death and to be cut off from your people for violating this ordinance,
si se te va a poner a muerte o a sacarte fuera de la comunidad por haber violado una de estas ordenanzas,
Jehovah certainly does not intend for you to be a citizen in his kingdom.
Ciertamente el Eterno no tiene no está de acuerdo en que tú vas a ser parte de su reino.
Now, go to Shemot 20.
Éxodos 20.
Chapter, verse
8. Éxodos capítulo 20, versículo 8.
And this is part of the 10 words.
Y esto es parte de los 10 words or the 10 commandments.
But same thing, 10 words. He spoke them, 10 words.
10 palabras.
Remember the day Shabbat, who set it apart for Elohim. You have 6 days to labor and do all your work, but the seventh day is a Shabbat for Jehovah, for your Elohim. On it, you are not to do any kind of work, not you, not your son, not your daughter, not your male or female slave, not your livestock, and not the foreigner staying with you inside the gates of your property. For 6 days, Jehovah made heaven and earth, the sea and everything in them. But on the seventh day, he rested. This is why Jehovah blessed the day Shabbat and separated it for himself. So there's a lot of rules for Shabbat.
Entonces hay muchas reglas para el Shabbat.
Everybody has to keep it.
todo el mundo tiene que guardarlo.
Your animal has to keep it.
Aún tus animales tienen que guardarlo.
Your slave has to keep it.
Tu esclavo tiene que guardarlo.
So everything stops, all of it, complete rest.
Todo se tiene que detener en el Shabbat.
So that's pretty specific.
Eso es muy específico.
So did God change the Shabbat ever?
¿Será que el Eterno entonces cambió el Shabbat?
Let's go to Yeshayahu.
Vamos a Isaías.
58.
Trece y catorce.
He's reading my mind. Okay, if you hold back your foot on Shabbat from pursuing your own interests on my holy day, if you call Shabbat a delight, Jehovah's holy day worth honoring, then honor it by not doing your usual things or pursuing your interests or speaking about them. If you do, you will find delight in Jehovah. He will make you ride on the heights of the land and feed you with the heritage of your ancestor Yaakov, for the mouth of Jehovah has spoken. Now, let's go to Hebrews.
Ahora vamos a Hebreos.
Rabbi Andrew likes to try to use this as evidence that, you know, coffee is biblical, but Hebrews, but you see, I like to say coffee is the number one drink of satanic seances worldwide. Well, Starbucks serves it, and more seances are held. I know. Hebrews 4:9-11.
Hebreos 4.
Okay, so this is after Yeshua.
Esto es después de Yeshua.
This is after Yeshua.
Después de Yeshua.
Died for our sins.
Murió, después que Yeshua murió por nuestros pecados.
After Rabbi Shaul.
Después de Rab Shaul.
Did his little stint down in Arabia for all these years.
Y se paró allí en Arabia por tanto tiempo.
After he did his ministry and wrote all these letters all around everywhere.
Después que él hizo su ministerio en todas las partes que él llegó y pudo predicar el evangelio.
So after that, this to the Hebrews.
Después de eso, él escribió esto a los hebreos.
So, there remains a Shabbat keeping for Elohim's people. For one who has entered Elohim's rest has also rested from his own works, as Elohim did from his. Therefore, let us do our best to enter that rest so that no one will fall short because of the same kind of disobedience. So,
entonces,
Rab Shaul, in the New Testament,
en el Nuevo Testamento,
calls failing to keep the Shabbat,
habló de faltar el Shabbat, de hacerlo,
disobedience,
una desobediencia.
So,
entonces,
you can go further,
puedes ir más profundo.
If you need more scriptures,
si necesitas más escrituras,
you can look up scriptures. I've limited this to 4 or 5.
Yo he limitado esta de 4 a 5.
But I can find so many Shabbat scriptures.
Yo te puedo encontrar muchas escrituras del Shabbat.
You can go to Yeshayahu 66.
Puedes irte a Isaías 66.
And read the chapter yourself and you'll see.
Y leer el capítulo por ti mismo.
That after this world is gone.
Y darte cuenta de que después que este mundo se haya terminado.
After heaven is gone.
Después que el cielo haya pasado,
there will be a keeping of Shabbat.
Habrá que guardar el Shabbat.
And Rosh Kodesh.
Y el Rosh Kodesh.
And the people who disobeyed it
Y las personas que lo desobedezcan
are outside,
están afuera
as corpses,
como cuerpos, o sea, cadáveres.
So that's the end of it. If you're not keeping Shabbat,
esto es el final de esto. Y si tú no guardas el Shabbat,
you are just simply not a citizen of the land.
Tú simplemente no eres un ciudadano de la tierra, del
one,
lugar.
One final thing for today,
y algo para finalizar.
If you are keeping Shabbat,
si estás guardando el Shabbat,
God doesn't care.
A Dios no le importa.
If your skin's black,
si tú eres negro o eres moreno, como lo quieran poner.
If you speak with a Latin accent,
si hablas así con un acento latino, oye chico.
If you speak with a southern accent,
o si hablas y'all,
or if you're a Yankee with a gigantic curly beard,
y si eres tal vez un Yankee de allá de Nueva York,
you are a citizen in God's kingdom.
Del norte, y esto es, y si tú haces todo eso, no importa ninguna de estas cosas, si haces el Shabbat, eres parte del reino del Eterno.
And I will see you guys next Shabbat with more of this class.
Y los voy a ver el próximo Shabbat con más de esta clase.
Shalom, this is Messianic Rabbi Andrew Dinnerman. I would personally like to thank you for tuning in to the Remnant's Call each and every week. You can listen to the full message on our website, bethgoyim.org. If you have drawn closer to the King of Kings, learned more about Him today, we are blessed. If you are blessed by these messages, please consider a donation to our ministry. You can go to our website, bethgoyim.org. That's BETHGOYIM.org. And click on the donate button. You do not have to have a PayPal account to donate. All you need is a debit card. Once again, thank you very much for listening to The Remnant's Call.
If you have not taken your first steps to be born again, just ask God's help. Remember, it's His loving grace that has come to find you. No one is worthy or able to reach God, but God can reach us, and He's reaching out to you now. Just open your heart and let Him in. His arms are open, and the blessing of salvation and eternal life are waiting for you. Don't let it wait any longer.
Shalom. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord lift His face and shine upon you. May the Lord be gracious unto you and give you His shalom.
Shalom. My name is Messianic Rabbi Andrew Dinnerman, and I invite you to come to visit our congregation. If you are in the tri-state area, come out and visit with us on Shabbat. We are a congregation of Jews and Gentiles living as one in the Messiah Yeshua. BGMC is a place of true worship. The focus never wanders from the Hebraic roots of our faith. Beth Goyim is rooted in the Word of God from Bereshit through to the Book of Revelation. Messiah's strong words against man-made tradition are carefully recorded in Matthew 7. That is the reason we only follow the straight-up instructions found in Scripture. Truly, the way, the truth, and the life. If you're looking for a deeper walk with Adonai, come out for our Tuesday evening Bible study called Messianic Torah Time. Come, spend the day with us on any Shabbat. We start at 11 a.m. with the sound of the ancient Hebrew shofar. Next, we offer our King praise and worship in English, Hebrew, and Spanish. After worship, we review the headlines in the previous week's news from around the globe, especially news from the Holy Land Israel. We don't just list the news headlines as current events, but we comb through the scriptures searching for clues to understand what they mean and then to help pinpoint prophetically our current position on Adonai's clock. After digesting all that modern information, we leave the world behind as we journey with our Adonai deep into his eternal word, not with just one or two scriptures, but usually seven or more scriptures. The spiritual nourishment and the richness of his kingdom become accessible to the ones who share this special time and seek them out. The day does not end there. Because Shabbat is so special to him, there is always so much more that our King desires to share. So instead of separating and leaving, we stay together as a family for potluck lunch and an afternoon study of our King's Word. We close the Shabbat together with the reading of the new week's parasha. That's the Torah portion. Even after those blessings, many of us just can't get enough. So the members bring prepared homemade foods to share while we all enjoy an uplifting movie together. If all that information is not quite enough, you can check out our website where you will find over 200 video teachings and biblical holy day studies. Under Messianic Torah Time, the Hebrew Roots button, you'll discover free studies on many, many different topics, including PowerPoint slide presentations. If Beth Goyim sounds like a place you'd love to visit, but you live outside the tri-state area, there is still a way to connect with us. We stream live on the internet on Tuesday, Thursday, and Shabbat. The website is www.bethgoyim.org. That's BethGoyim.org. Our phone number is 973-338-7800 or 978-2-YESHUA. That's 978, the number 2, Yeshua. Shalom.